30 days in advance of where we should be. Here we are, the first full week in June, temperatures in the 90s. We expect that. What we do not expect, mid to upper 90s during this time of the year. We will have a few storms later on today. It is going to be hot and breezy for us with the wind out of the west, afternoon high of 95. Now, if you're along the Gulf Coast, our biggest concern, not for storms, but for the chance for some moderate rip currents, and you need to be aware of that, especially if you don't go to the beach too often. It is going to be sunny and hot, and we'll have water temperature right around 83, which is awfully nice for us for this time of the year. And then here's the forecast for the next couple of days. We've got some good rain chances tomorrow and Wednesday, about 60%. Most of that's going to be north of I-10, south of Montgomery. That's certainly an area of the state that does need some good, sustained rain, and it looks like it's going to be in our forecast for the next couple of days. But again, rain is not in our forecast significantly for today, about a 30% chance for a shower. Summer, of course, means sunshine, means fun, and heat. Water, bugs also can provide you with some problems from time to time. Here's more on that story.
Summertime means fun in the sun, but it can also be a risky season with families hitting the beach, hitting the pool, and hitting the trail on bikes. Now, with a smartphone in your pocket, keeping everyone safe can get a little easier. Don't let the sun burn you when you're on the sand or poolside. The Sunwise app from the Environmental Protection Agency gives the daily and hourly forecast for UV rays wherever you are, or wherever you're headed. The Suntan Watcher app for iPhone can remind you to turn over, reapply sunscreen, or check on the kids with the help of an alarm. Whether you've got a 10-speed or training wheels, the Bike Safety app for iPhone has tips for staying safe on two wheels. And the SOS app from the American Red Cross for Android has quick answers for immediate safety concerns from bug bites to barbecue burns, though it shouldn't be used as a replacement for professional care. I'm Karen Kafa, and you're now clicked in.
That's pretty cool. Still to come on News 4 this morning, a Chicago pastor wants to raise millions to end violence, but wait until you hear how he plans to get that money. And a new drug may help in the fight of breast cancer. These stories, News 4 this morning.
I don't want cheap flooring.
Resist a soft style tail ends June 17th.
You've been walking on us for years and we really do appreciate it.
Got a legal question? WTVY.com and Brock and Stout have partnered to offer our viewers free legal advice. Go to WTVY.com under community and ask them your questions today.
Are you struggling with debt? Contact the attorneys at Brock and Stout today. Stop harassing creditors and keep your home, automobile, and other possessions. Call now for a free consultation and get your life back on track. Contact the attorneys at Brock and Stout today.
The Neelands are coming to the Dothan Civic Center live in concert June 15th for the Dothan National Night Out Benefit. Come out and hear this dynamic gospel group. Also performing is the Dothan Police Department's Apostle. All proceeds benefit the Dothan Police Department's in concert at the Dothan Civic Center June 15th. For tickets, call 615-3175.
Welcome back, friends. 24 minutes past the top of the hour, a man in Chicago known as the Rooftop Pastor for his work to improve the community takes on a new mission this week. Diane Pathew reports on the pastor's plan to walk across the nation.
walk across America because too many black boys are dying at the hands of other black boys, and ain't nobody saying nothing, and somebody's got to face the challenge.
And Pastor Corey Brooks is ready to face his next challenge. He's taking his mission to end gun violence on the South Side even further.
It's about the children in the neighborhood.
He's hitting streets all across America on foot.
I'm excited, a little nervous, but I'm excited about it.
You'll remember Pastor Brooks as the man who lived on the rooftop of an abandoned motel for 94 days. He's trying to bring attention to Project Hood. It's his plan to build a community and economic development center near 66th and King Drive. The motel had become riddled with drug dealing and prostitution, and he wanted it to come down. Through his fundraising and with some help from movie mogul Tyler Perry, Pastor Brooks made his first goal. The motel did come down. And so did he.
94 days in prayer.
Nadine Williams has been watching Pastor Brooks flourish and make positive changes in this community.
For him to be a young man and doing wonderful things for us is just magnificent that he has the courage to do what the Lord is asking him to do, because he could just say, well, I can't do that. It's too much. But he's the go-getter and he's going for it.
His next goal, to raise $15 million for the center. So he plans to walk from New York City to Los Angeles, raising awareness of how violence affects everyone in every city.
I believe that people not only in Chicago and America are going to give, and I'm believing with everything in me that we're going to raise the money to build a wonderful facility.
He knows he may not raise all of the money along the way, but he hopes he draws a lot of attention to a big problem.
Well, they certainly got my attention this morning. Pastor Brooks will start his walk in New York City tomorrow. He's already secured sponsors for the trip, including Walgreens and New Balance Shoes. And looks like a great cause there. Now let's join Demetria for today's For Your Health headlines.
In today's For Your Health, an experimental drug is offering new hope in the fight against breast cancer. A 3-year clinical trial found the drug, commonly known as TDM1, slowed the progression of a certain advanced form of breast cancer better than a standard treatment. The drug is a combination of cancer drug Herceptin and a chemotherapy drug. Researchers say, though it's not a cure, it is a, quote, huge deal in terms of slowing down an aggressive form of the cancer. Doctors also say they saw fewer side effects, giving their patients a better quality of life. Right now, only women participating in the clinical trial have access to this new drug until it gets approved in the United States. While most new moms plan to exclusively breastfeed for at least 3 months, new study in the journal Pediatrics shows only 1/3 of them actually follow through. Researchers found mothers who were married or who had a previous baby were more likely to breastfeed as long as they planned. The mothers who were obese, smoked, or had longer intended breastfeeding durations were less likely to meet their intention. And too much exercise may be too much of a good thing. Recent research suggests chronic training for and competing in marathons, triathlons, and long-distance bicycle races may cause structural changes to the heart and large arteries that can lead to muscle injuries and rhythm abnormalities. Last March, legendary ultramarathoner Micah True died suddenly while on a routine 12-mile training run. An autopsy found his heart was enlarged and scarred. That's pretty interesting news there.
Yep. Who would have thought?
Too much
exercise, huh? Hey, stick around because when News 4 this morning returns, Connor Vernon is up next with another look at the forecast, and we're 27 minutes past the hour.
Raising money for disabled seniors. We'll tell you how you can get involved. That's right after the break.
Have you ever wanted to sell something but were intimidated by those mega auction websites? Do you have something that is too big to ship around the world? WTVY Hometown Classifieds is a website for people here in the Wiregrass. You can sell almost anything on WTVYHometownClassifieds.com. All listings are free. So give it a try at WTVYHometownClassifieds.com.
Read to a child today and spark a lifetime of ambition.
Some risks are obviously not worth taking.
Watch where you're going!
Some aren't as obvious, but could be just as deadly. Like the risk for type 2 diabetes, especially if you're over 45 or overweight. Take the diabetes risk test. It's free and takes less than a minute. Type 2 diabetes is one risk you can't afford to take. So stop diabetes before it stops you.
You're watching News 4 This Morning with Ben Stanfield, Demetria McClinton, and meteorologist Connor Vernon.
Time now is 6:30. Let's take a look at what's going on around the country. If you've got some travel plans, we don't have any problems in Atlanta this morning in terms of weather problems. And you know, you got to get to Atlanta to get to about anywhere, whether you're flying out of the Tallahassee area, flying out of Dothan, flying out of Panama City. If you're going to Atlanta, again, no big problems there. Temperatures in the 70s around the southeast, and you're going to find some 50s way up in the northeast, but that's about the extent of it. Here's a good look what's going on out west. They have some warm temperatures also, and it's going to continue to be that way. Overnight, we have some big storms in the northern sections of Alabama. See this little system right here? This is what triggered not only the chance for some severe storms, but also some tornadoes overnight. Those red boxes, tornado watch boxes, the yellow boxes, of course, the severe thunderstorm areas where the potential was. In our area, we're going to have about a 30% chance for some storms later today. Some of those, of course, could end up reaching severe limits. We don't expect a big breakout for severe weather like they're having in the northern sections of Alabama and Tennessee right now. But the best news is that most of those showers that do occur are actually going to be north of I-10. Now, all along the Gulf Coast, areas are going to be sunny and hot, but for us to have about a 30% chance today, but our rain chances get even better. Here's a quick look, a little closer in view of what's going on up in the northwestern section of Alabama right now. But what we're anticipating, our rain chances are going to start to go up tomorrow night and even into Wednesday, and that's going to give us a better chance for rain than we've seen quite a while. About a 60% chance tomorrow night, and then on into Wednesday. Around the area, temperatures in the 70s, as we mentioned. Huntsville's at 68 right now. Atlanta is at 71, and Tupelo is at 70 degrees. Here's what we're expecting a little later today. 82 to come in right around the 9 o'clock hour. We're expected to be in the upper 80s, pushing 90 by noon. Afternoon high today right around 95. We'd have to be in the low 100s to be even close to the record, but the best news that we've had in quite a while, Ben and Demetria, is the fact that we're going to have a 60% chance over a number of days starting tomorrow, because we certainly do need the rain in this area.
Very good. We certainly could use the rain, Connor, and look forward to it later this week. It's 32 minutes past the top of the hour, and isolation, it's a major concern for senior citizens. It can develop into depression and loneliness, but one business is going to try and change that. The First Avenue Mini Market held its first fundraiser to raise money for a new senior center on Saturday. The center is to be built in the Dothan community and will include activities that disabled seniors can take part in. Walking trails, bird watching, picnic areas, just a few of the new features.
The senior center is going to be staged on acres of land. We're hoping that somebody will donate maybe some land to us and we could get going a little bit sooner.
All proceeds will go towards the new senior center.
That's actually work that they're doing out there.
Yeah, it looks pretty cool. Dog parks and bird watching. That sounds like my kind of gig.
Exactly.
You know?
And still to come on News 4 this morning, we'll tell you why thousands of people are so happy. You see them waving their flags right there.
Look at that. That was a cool festivities over the weekend. And be sure to log on to the web channel, WTVY.com. We want to know, do you buy local produce? That's today's poll question. It's on the web channel. If you can't find it, send me an email. I'll show you exactly where it's at. We'll be right back.
The war had been going on for 2 years, and I got the calling. I got the calling to join the service and support the boys over there. I never thought that I would have PTSD. I thought that I had enough coping skills.
I don't think anybody who goes into combat could ever honestly say that they're not different when they come home.
My life's changed. What you take as a simple thing is not so simple for me anymore.
It's like a pressure cooker. And, you know, you want somebody desperately to trip that valve. You know, you want to, like, you know, lose all of that anger and angst.
I would say to those people that are out there, get educated. Don't brush us aside and don't count us out.
Hear more of their stories at usoinvisiblewounds.org. The wounds are invisible. The stories are real.
What will you build? What will be your legacy? How will you make the world a better place? If you're searching for an answer to these questions, Habitat for Humanity can help. It's a curious thing, thought Habitat for Humanity. We build houses and something more, something extraordinary. A Habitat build site is where laying one foundation can transform a neighborhood. Where painting a room colors an entirely new outlook on life. Where installing a window offers a clearer vision of the future. Where renovating a home can renew a community. Where setting a level can balance a life. You see, Habitat for Humanity builds houses and so much more. So what will you build? Visit Habitat.org to learn more.
Closed captioning is brought to you as a public service by Dunkin' Donuts and WTVY.
Welcome back. It is 36 minutes past the top of the hour, or if you want to flip that around, 24 minutes away from a new hour.
I like being optimistic. I like the second one.
There you go. My name is Ben Stanfield. Good morning to you.
And I'm Demetria McClinton. And in national news this morning, George Zimmerman spent his first night back in a jail cell in Sanford, Florida. He surrendered Sunday afternoon after a judge revoked the 28-year-old's bond after prosecutors argued Zimmerman and his wife lied about how much money they had in order to get a lower bail set in April. Today, Zimmerman's lawyer is expected to file a motion for a new bond hearing. Zimmerman is charged with second-degree murder in the death of Trayvon Martin.
And investigators are trying to figure out what caused a commercial jet to crash in a neighborhood in Nigeria. A military official there says there are reports the pilots radioed about engine problems just before the accident Sunday. The Dana Air flight went down in Lagos.
This weekend, the four-day celebration continues today with an outdoor concert next to Buckingham Palace featuring Paul McCartney and Elton John. Now, yesterday, more than 1,000 vessels sailed along a seven-mile stretch of the Thames River. Now, the Queen has 60 years, a long time. Was that your British accent?
Maybe so.
Awfully weak.
Cheerio, Conover. Good morning to you. How's the forecast?
Hey, we're in for a pretty good day for some storms, Bama. Not only had it for severe storms overnight, but also overnight. Didn't develop. That's good. But you can see the squall line that is coming out of Tennessee and moving into the northwestern corners of Alabama right now as we speak. Certainly Birmingham's going to be impacted. Temperatures are no big thing for us, about right for us for this time. Talked about we're ahead of where our temperatures really should be, but about 70 is about pretty good for us. Panama City 71, St. Joe's 74 this morning, back towards the Destin area there at 78. Most of the storms that are going to occur today for us will be north of the beach. It's going to be north of Certainly bigger rain chances in our forecast once we get into tomorrow. For the rest of the day, we're going to have late in the day. It's going to be certainly will be around 95. We mentioned the chance for some showers along the Gulf Coast. Not that great today. Most of the rainfall will be in the inland areas. But the is if you're having a chance for some rip currents, to be sure and ask a little about that if you don't know what we're talking about here. Just mention the word rip current. They'll be more than happy to tell you what it is. Water temperature is 83, which is going to feel terrific for folks. And that temperature is right for us today. Notice on the, I think we were right past the 5 day somehow there. Punching the button a little too quick here this morning. But we're looking for the rain showers about a 30% chance today, 60% chance for our area tomorrow, and 60% tomorrow night. Ben, Dimitri, it's going to continue to be a 60% chance for us right into Tuesday night and into Wednesday. And that's great news for us. We need that rain, certainly in the interior areas right here.
Very good. Thank you, Mr. Vernon. We'll catch you over here at the table shortly.
Okay, right. Good.
Hey, Dimitri, Friday our poll question was, are you prepared with an emergency storm supply kit? Now, my question is, are you?
Honestly, I'm not.
No?
No, but I do plan on getting some more supplies. I need to get my batteries, my flashlights, and generator.
Ramen noodles.
I would never go back to ramen noodles. After college, I swear I would never go back.
You know, I eat them every now and then, just for the taste.
Oh, goodness.
Just remind me of where I was.
Okay, and how far
you... And how far I've come, you know. I'll eat ramen noodles one day and then have a steak the next. So, interesting stuff there. But here's the answer to the poll question. 24.1% of you say, yes, you are prepared. 75.9% probably fall into that category with Demetria and myself. I would say I'm somewhat prepared. I'm probably 50-50 prepared.
So what do you have?
I got flashlights everywhere.
Okay.
And, you know, a flashlight doubles. I got one of the big ones. Doubles down as a weapon and a light, a source of power. So
very resourceful.
Yeah. You know, you should have one. You should carry in the car with you. You never know. You never know. But anyways, hey, coming up later on News 4 this morning, Royce Reagan joins us for Talk of the Town from Mariana.
Plus, Mr. Food is at one of my favorite places in the world, Disney World.
Join me all this week as we visit the Walt Disney World Resort and share magical recipes that you won't want to miss.
Uh-huh.
Come on.